Section 4.5 is kind of a strange little section called graphing with a calculator. So last class we learned how to graph by making a table of values, looking for a bunch of points, and then putting them on a coordinate plane, right? Well, it turns out there's these wonderful calculators called graphing calculators, and they will find a whole bunch of points, way more points than we find, and it'll get it a whole lot faster, and will do the graphing for you. So the most popular one of these calculators that are used in high schools all over British Columbia and Canada, I'm sure, is the TI-83. TI stands for Texas Instruments, and 83 is the model number. There's also the TI-83 Plus, there's the TI-84, the TI-84 Plus, which I have. There's the TI Inspire, which is the new one. Inspire. There's all sorts of them. And to tell the truth, I don't like them much. Isn't that awful? I'm not a huge fan of them. A lot of math teachers, they do almost all the math in grade 11 and 12 especially with graphing calculators. And in my opinion, what happens when you do lots of stuff in graphing calculators is you don't really learn too much about what the math is all about. You learn how to punch buttons. Now, that's just my opinion. I do use graphing calculators. I probably don't use them as much as other teachers. Okay, another reason I don't like the TI-83, I do like using graphs, using technology, but I don't like using this thing. What I like using more than that is a website. There's a bunch of different websites, but one website I really like is this one. It's called Desmos.com, and this is, in my opinion, more powerful. It's easier to use. It's free, so this is a wonderful thing. These calculators, here's a big example of it. The Texas Instrument one, the TI-83, you can see it right there. This thing costs you about $120 if you buy it new. I wouldn't suggest you buy one. We have some you can borrow, and also you never use them in university, so you don't have to feel you have to run out and get it because you'll need it for university. You won't. They don't use these. You're not allowed. Okay, so anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to do some graphing here using graphing calculator. So let's go back here, and the first thing I'm going to graph is y equals negative x minus 3 squared plus 4. Okay, if we were going to use the TI-83, what you would do when you're graphing is you hit this y equals button up there. So I'd hit that, and you get something that looks like this. Now, the y equals, so the one, another one of the bad things about the TI-83 is all your equations have to be of the form y equals. So for example, this first one's great. Y equals, we could certainly do this. We could type in negative bracket x minus 3 squared plus 4, and then you'd hit graph. So maybe I'll just do this one and also show you any other type of calculator. So you'd hit negative, not this button. This is a takeaway button. This is a negative button. This causes problems for people all the time. So I'd hit negative. You see, I have to hit a little bit below it because this is a free thing that I found on the internet. Whoops. Open bracket, x minus 3, so x, this time I'd put minus or take away, so I'd hit this button, 3, close the bracket, then I'd have to raise it to the square, or I could just square it, I could hit this one, the squared button here, so x negative x minus 3 squared plus, painful to watch me do this, isn't it? Plus 4, come on 4, there it is, and then you hit graph. And it should show up. You see, it takes a while, and that's what it looks like right there. Yay! And then it's really hard to read any of the points because it's so small. Sometimes you don't have the window. This is called the window. Sometimes you don't have the window setting correctly, and so you won't be able to see it at all, and it gets all confusing. It's really kind of disastrous, I think, at times. So if we go to our Desmos, though, all I do is I go into this window right here, and I just type in exactly what it says. And what it said was y equals negative, there's some brackets here, so I'll hit the brackets, x minus 3, and then I have to put squared. You hit this a squared to get your squared, plus 4, and boom, there it is. And I can actually read some stuff here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my sheet we're working on. I'm going to put in some of these points. So you can see, look at this, it even shows you some of the points. It shows you this point's 3, 4. Another important point would be this one. It's another pretty point, right? When I say pretty point, it's a point that is exactly at two whole numbers, so like 2 and 3. It's not a real term, I just call it that, pretty point. So we've got a pretty point there, we've got pretty points here and here at 2, 3 and 4, 3, and we have pretty points here at 1, 0. That's the x-intercept, and another x-intercept here at 5, 0. And if I move down, I have a y-intercept at 0, negative 5, and there's another point here at 0, 6. So I'm not going to flip back and forth and show you the points, but hopefully you understand how I do this. And I just go over here, and some of those points I saw, it'll be easier for you because you'll have the Desmos graph in front of you. And I would just go to 3, 4, which was one of the points. And I don't know if you remember the points we said. We said both of these were points, and we said both of these were points. And then it was at -5 here was the other point. And what we get is a parabola. You're going to do tons of parabola stuff in grade 11, so it comes down like this. And what the Desmos calculator, or the TI-83, has done is found that all these points on that blue line, they all satisfy this equation. If you pick any point on here and put it into this equation, it works. Let's try point. How about this point here? This point right here is 6, negative 5, right? So my x value is 6. That means I put 6 in here. 6 take away 3 is 3. 3 squared is 9. Then slap that negative on, so it's negative 9. And negative 9 plus 4 is negative 5. Hey, that's right. The y value is negative 5. All these points work, not just the pretty points, all of them work. And the graphing calculator helped us figure it out. Okay, here's another one. 7x minus 5y equals 35. See, here's a problem. If you were using the TI-83, if you were using this thing, you would not be able to put this in right now. Why? Because, I'll clear this, because, come on, clear, because I need to have it equal y equal. This doesn't say y equals. So what you'd have to do is you'd have to isolate the y. You want to get y to be by itself and positive. So I'm not going to spend a lot of time with this, but what I would probably do is add 5y to both sides because we want my y's to be positive. So that takes care of those. And now what I have is 7x equals 35 plus 5y. Oh, let's subtract 35 from both sides. Okay, careful, you can't actually subtract anything there, you're just going to rewrite it. 7x minus 35 equals 5y, and finally you're going to divide both sides by 5. So you get y equals, this is gone, 7x minus 35, you're going to have to put that in brackets in your TI-83, and then you're going to have to divide it by 5. Okay, a little bit complicated, definitely possibility of making some mistakes there. But if you're using the Desmos calculator, it's a lot easier. First of all, just let me circle this and say, for the TI-83. That's what you'd have to input for the TI-83. But for the Desmos calculator, we can just put that right there. 7x minus 5y equals 35. So let's do that. We go back to our calculator here. If I want, I can just turn this one off by clicking there. Isn't that nice? Or I can get rid of it altogether. Okay, and I'm going to put 7x minus 5y. You see, I can put it exactly the way it first looked. I don't have to isolate the y. And I get a line. Oh, I can't see. I can see one point here. It goes through 5, 0. And I can't see down here. That's okay. Just click the mouse, hold it, and lift up, and you can see. So it goes through 5, 0, and 0, negative 7. All right, I'm ready. I go back here, and I'm going to put one dot at 5, 0, another dot at 0, negative 7. And we could see it's a line, so I'm ready. Now, some of you might be saying, but wait a minute, didn't you say we should always get 3 points? Yeah, I did say that, but that's when you were doing the calculations. And you know what's different between you and a graphing calculator? Graphing calculators don't make mistakes. So you don't need to do the third point because obviously it's correct. The graphing calculator showed that to you, unless you typed it in incorrectly. So this is your graph right here. Again, every single point on this black line will satisfy the equation up here. Should we try one or not? Let's just try one of the easy ones. Let's try 5, 0. Let's try that point right there. If we put 5 in here and 0 in here, does it work? 7 times 5 is 35. Take away 5 times 0 is 0, so 35 take away 0 is 35. Yeah, it works. Every point on this black line, even the non-pretty points, will work. Okay, a couple more. Here's an interesting one. If you were to put this into your TI-83, what a drag. You have to change this so it says y equals, and right now it says x equals. How do we do that? Well, this is kind of getting into the end of this course that we haven't even learned yet, but what you'd have to do is you'd have to multiply both sides by the lowest common denominator, which is y minus 1. So don't worry about this too much, but what you'd be doing is multiplying both sides by y minus 1. Why do you do that? Because these two would then cancel. So what you'd be left with on this side is x times y minus 1. And on the other side, all there'd be is 3. Then you'd do mountains, as I call them. We'll talk a lot about mountains soon. And what you'd get is called the distributive property, actually. X times y is xy. X times negative 1, it's negative x, equals 3. Remember what our goal is? It's to get this y by itself. So let's get rid of this x first by adding. So we get xy equals 3 plus x, or x plus 3 if you want. We want this y by itself. Right now it's x times y. We better divide both sides by x, because that'll get rid of this x right there. So what we have for our final answer is y equals 3 plus x, or x plus 3, it's the same thing. Put that in brackets if you're going to do it in your TI-83, and then divide it by x, and that'll be your answer. So that took a little bit of work, and it's quite possible to make a mistake. Or with our lovely Desmos calculator, you can just put x equals 3 over y minus 1. Desmos doesn't care if you put x equals or y equals. Desmos is awesome. So let's do it. So we put x equals, and it equals 3 divided by y minus 1. And we're done. And there's our graph. Now, is that the whole graph? I actually don't think it is. Let's drag this down a little bit. Yeah, there's the rest of it up there. Okay, so here's what we got to graph. Now, there's a few very important, or pretty points we could use here. There's one at 3, 2. There's one at 1, 4. And you see what happens here? This line is getting closer and closer and closer, but never quite reaching. It's getting closer and closer, but it's never quite reaching the point of 1 here. Same here. It's getting closer and closer this way, but it's never reaching that y value of 1 either. That means there's an asymptote right there at 1, which is more a grade 11 topic. There's also an asymptote here at the y-axis. It's getting closer and closer to the y-axis, but never reaching it. It's getting closer and closer to the y-axis here, but never reaching it. So you're just going to pick some of those pretty points I talked about here, here, maybe this one at negative 3, 0, maybe this one at negative 1, negative 2, and then you're going to remember the asymptotes at y equals 1 and at the y-axis. Okay, again, it's kind of awkward going back and forth, but hopefully you get the idea. You'd have your piece of paper, you'd have your graphing calculator, the Desmos Work website in front of you, and you just fill in some of the points that you can read off of there. So some of the points we saw were at 3, 2, and there was another pretty point at 1, 4, and what we said is that there was an asymptote, so it's getting closer and closer and closer, but never touching the y-axis. It's obviously going to come down through this point, and then it got closer and closer and closer, but never reached the y equals 1 line, this line right here. Okay. There was also a pretty point down here. It's just kind of like a reflection. There's a pretty point at negative 3, 0. There was a pretty point at 1, negative 2. It got closer and closer and closer, but never reached the, whoops, that line shouldn't actually reach it. And it should get closer and closer and closer, but never reached this line. So again, this is for the TI-83 or 84 or whatever TI calculator you have. And one last one, this is the worst case for the TI-83, because again, if we were doing this in the TI-83, you'd want to get the y, it has to be y equals, so we need to get the y by itself. Let's add y squared, like move the y squared to the other side, right? So we're going to have x squared equals 25 plus y squared. If you're not following what I'm doing here, it's not really a big deal. We still have to talk about this kind of stuff later in the course. Then I want to get the y by itself, so let's subtract 25 from both sides. And now we have x squared minus 25 equals y squared. And to solve that, you have to do the opposite of squaring, which is take the square root. So we have y equals the square root of x squared minus 25. Now, have I mentioned this? I think I have. When you solve equations like we're doing here by taking a square root, you have to put plus and minus. Here's what's really annoying about the Texas Instrument calculators. You have to actually enter two different equations to get this graph properly. You have to enter y equals positive, or just the square root of x squared minus 25. So that'd be your y1. If you look back here, you can see there's like y1 and y2. So on the first line, you'd have to enter x square root of x squared minus 25. And then the second line, this y2 line, you would enter y2 equals negative the square root of x squared minus 25. Now, I'm not going to show it to you, but if you were to do that, you'd get two graphs that kind of meet, but not completely, and that's very annoying. So this is for the TI-83. You have to do this whenever you're graphing something that's not a function, and this is not a function here, as you'll see in just a second. By the way, let's go back and just quickly ask you, is this a function? Yes, it is. It passes the vertical line test. Is this a function? Yes, it is. It passes the vertical line test. Is this a function? Yes, it is. It passes the vertical line test. Remember, we talked about this before. It's getting closer and closer, but it's never touching. So it's actually getting further and further to the right. It passes the vertical line test. Is this one a function? We don't know yet, but let's graph it. X squared minus y squared equals 25. So we go here, get rid of this. X squared, we can do, it's no problem. Desmos doesn't mind that. X squared minus y squared equals 25. And we get this crazy thing. Now, I can't see it very well. So what I can do is I can use my mouse scroller or whatever you guys call that thing. I don't know what it's called. And you get this. So we definitely have pretty points at 5 and negative 5. There's not really any other pretty points. So what you might want to do is just look, get the general idea of the shape, and see where does it leave. Our graph, remember, that I've drawn for you, only goes up to 10. So at 10, it's at about 8.5. And at 10, it's also at negative 8.5. And at negative 10, it's up at 8.5, and at negative 10, it's also down at negative 8.5. So if I go back here, I said there were pretty points at 5 and negative 5. And I said there, when I was way out here at 10, it was about at 8.5, and it was also about at negative 8.5, and same over here at negative 10. It's at negative 8.5 and 8.5, and you saw the shape. It was basically, this is really hard to draw, but it's basically like this and this. That's terrible, but can you please forgive me? And like this and this. This should be perfect reflections. Mine aren't going to be perfect reflections at all. It's pretty bad. This is called a hyperbola. We don't study them at all anymore. I used to study them in grade 12, but don't do it anymore, which is too bad. All right, we're finished. Is this a function? No, absolutely not. This fails the vertical line test all over the place, right? There you go. Fails the vertical line test right there, and here, and here, and here, and here, and here. It also fails it here, 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 here. Not a function. But that's how a graphing calculator works. Won't be doing too much of it with me, but if you get lucky and get a different teacher in grade 11, 12, you might spend half your life doing it. All right, have a good day, and enjoy Desmos, or the TI Stinkin' 83.